The mutual fund and ETF industry continues to undergo rapid change. Recently, I talked with Sean Collins about what the trend lines tell us about where money is going and just how active and passive management are working together.
There's lots of choice out there for investors. We have over 10,000 mutual funds and exchange-traded funds in combination. There are about 7,000 actively managed mutual funds, 450 index mutual funds, 1,800 exchange-traded funds. There's a wide range of choices within each of those categories.
Sean, a lot of people look at the data and the trend lines going on in the market, and they say active management is really on its way out and passive is going to continue to take over. What do you see in the data?
No, not at all. Active management is going to be with us always. What we're seeing now is an increase in the demand for index mutual funds and indexed ETFs. That doesn't mean there's not active management. There is. What's going on is there's a migration of active management from inside of funds to outside of funds. So, for example, an advisor might help you pick a bundle of ETFs that are passively managed, give you an initial asset allocation. That's active management because you're making choices about what you're going to do. And then the financial advisor would work with you so that over time, perhaps you rebalance your allocations in each one of those ETFs according to changing market circumstances, according to changing personal circumstances, like you could be getting older. You want to put more money into fixed income as you grow older generally. So all of those things are active management. It's just occurring outside of the fund as opposed to inside the fund.
Sean, the other thing people may not realize is that passive management is growing in particular categories at a rapid clip, but there are others where it still seems that active is really where investors are gravitating more.
Most of the passive management to date has been primarily in equity and primarily in U.S. domestic equity in particular. Areas like world equity and bond funds, we've still seen most of the growth in actively managed funds. Now, to be sure, there is growth in ETFs and bond funds, bond index funds that invest in those categories, but still predominantly those would be actively managed areas.
So when investors are looking at their fund choices, they really want to think broadly.
Absolutely. So you want to pick a suite of funds that match your characteristics, perhaps with the help of a financial advisor, perhaps changing those suite or mix over time. But you want to look across the range of funds so that you get a beta that sort of fits your circumstances. But also, you don't want to miss funds because you don't want to leave any alpha on the table. So you want to, it's a good idea probably to look across the range of funds.